In this presentation, I'm going to show you situations where you have to start thinking about not just focusing on developing themes, but finding out the connection between the themes so that you'll be able to address the research question. Before I talk about the three things, let me just give you a brief information about qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis suggests looking at your data, identifying significant information, developing codes, finding out connection between the codes, and coming up with themes, and then using the themes to address your research question. Sometimes you have to go beyond just developing themes and then come up with a theory. So what is a theory? In qualitative study, a theory is simply a statement that shows relationship among concepts used in explaining a phenomenon or a process. When do you have to think about going beyond developing themes? When you reach a stage where you realize that individual themes cannot independently address the research question, you have to think about looking into the relationship between the themes and then coming up with a theory or a model to help address your research question. Another condition is when you plan to develop a model or a theory. So when you want to develop a model or theory, you have to find out the connection between the themes, and then based on that, you'll be able to come up with a proposed theory, and then you can even compare the theory that you have or the model that you have with existing or new data to see whether the theory can reflect what is in the data and also explain the phenomenon or a process that you want to explain. Another situation is when you want to use your findings to examine the conceptual or theoretical framework that you have developed. Based on that, then you have to think about going beyond having themes and also thinking about a connection between the themes so that you'll be able to compare what you found in the data or what your findings are with the theoretical or conceptual framework. It will help you to maybe confirm the conceptual framework. It can help you to also maybe make an adjustment to the conceptual or theoretical framework that you have developed. So these are the three situations where you may have to think about the connection between themes so that you can come up with a theory or a model to help address your research question and also explain a phenomenon or a process. But you cannot go beyond developing themes without thinking about the data, right? Sometimes, because of the knowledge that you have about the subject matter, you may be tempted to just think about a connection between the themes that you have without thinking about the data that you have. When you are thinking about a relationship, you always have to compare what you have come up with, maybe the proposed relationship between the themes that you have with the data. You can, you know, compare it with the existing data, or you can collect more the data to do the comparison so that the themes that you come up with, or the theory or the model or the relationship between the themes, reflect what is in the data. You don't want to create anything that the data cannot support. Everything should be driven by the data. So the construction of the connection between the themes that you have, the development of the theory should be informed by the data that you have. So that's what I have for you concerning when you have to think about developing the connection between the themes that you have and coming up with a theory or a model. Let's have a conversation. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be happy to address them for you. Thank you for your time.